myself Nazneen Akka. Welcome to my study channel Naz Studies. Today my video is on absorption of water. So let's study about how the absorption of water take place. We know in the process of plant, the plant water from the soil is taken by the root, then from the root it is transported upwards. So we deal with these two things. One is how the water is absorbed. Second is ascent of sap. So absorption of water, it take for suppose this is plant, this one is root. So we will study how the water first absorb air by the root. After absorbing, how it moves upward. So this is called as ascent of sap. Ascent of sap, the movement of water and minerals. Sap is your waters and minerals, it together form sap. So sap, one is we study about absorption of water, how the water is absorbed, water molecules are absorbed by the root, then how it moves upward, that will discuss in the ascent of sap.
So transport of water deals with
absorption of water. And second is your ascent of sap. Ascent of sap. So first we discuss about absorption of water. How the water is absorbed from the root and how the process is, how the transfer takes place in a cell during the absorption of water. How the water moves in a cell. So we know I am drawing this diagram of this.
Drawing the diagram of root anatomy.
This is root here, this one is root here. We know in root here is present where the water molecule is absorbed from the soil. From the soil, water is absorbed by this root here. The second layer is your epidermis. After the epidermis, there is a layer cortex. Then this layer is your endodermis. Next to cortex come endodermis. This one is your frame. And this one is your cambium formation, and after that there is a xylem. This one is cortex, endodermis. See, this I have made the structures of the cells by which the water is can pass through by this one. Now we discuss about movement of water. So how the movement of water take place? This is the diagram of root cell. Okay, movement of water. So movement of water take place by two ways. One is called apoplast, another one is called symplast. These are the two mechanisms, the two process by which water moves. So how the water moves in apoplast movement and how the water moves in symplast process. So what happened in apoplast? Apoplast movement is movement through the cell wall and intercellular space. Means the water is passed from the root to the, I will use another marker. The water is passed from the root here to the cortex from the cell wall. Okay, it goes to the cell wall, then it crosses the intercellular space, then cell wall, then intercellular space. In this way, the movement of water is like this. Okay, the water moves like this, means it crosses the cell wall and intercellular space. It not move from cell to cell. It not move from cell to cell or inside the cell to one cell to another cell. Not like that. Water is moving in the outward layer. For example, this one is cell. Then water is moving from the cell wall and through the intercellular space, means the space between the cells. Water is moving like that in case of apoplast movement. In the most of the water that moves through the apoplast system is more as compared to the symplast. Here, after moving the apoplast, after moving the water through the cell wall and intercellular space, there come endodermis. In endodermis, there is a layer that is your suberin layer, or that is called as Casparian strait, that block the passage of water. So here the apoplast water, movement of water through apoplast, here it changes its directions and through the passage cell. Through the passage cell, it moves through the endodermis. Why? Because here there is a blockage of Suberian strait, Suberian or Casparian strait, that doesn't allow water to pass through. So it moves through the passage cell, and that is through the cell, that is between the cell, means it follows in plastic movement. Then after coming out from the endodermis, then it again follows the cell wall and intercellular space. And like this process, it enters where? Like this process, it enters up to the xylem. So apoplast movement is movement through the cell wall and intercellular space. It doesn't move cell to cell. Means inside cell to cell movement nahi hota in case of apoplastic movement. Only jab endodermis step mein jaise aake pahunchta hai, wahan because of Suberian or Casparian strip, the passage of water is not allowed. That's why here it moves, it follows the path just like simple plastic, that it moves within the cell, and then again escorts from it, it again go to follow the apoplastic movement. That is from cell wall and intercellular and it is the gel. And most of the water that move in this process is just like apoplastic movement. Now come to symplast movement. So what is about symplast movement? Symplast is a process in which water move from one cell to other cell. From one cell to other cell. How? It is via plasmodesmata. Means if the water moves through the symplastic way, then it moves cell to cell. See, I will use this color. Cell to cell more water is moving. So between the two cells there is a plasmodesmata that connect the two cells and help in movement of water or minerals or solution. So in case of apoplastic movement there is a movement of water, but in case of symplast we see there is a movement of solution, we can say, because here it is mixed with waters as enter the cell, means it is mixed with the cell type also, so many component. So it is movement of solution, we can say, in case of symplast. So movement of water take place from one cell to another cell. There is a plasmodesmata connection that connect the two cell and it help in passage of waters. It move like this here through the passage cell, because the cascading strip is there in endodermis. So here also in symplast the water moves to the passage cell, again it moves to the cell to cell and reach the xylem. So these two processes there in movement of water, where the maximum water absorption take place through apoplast and as compared to the symplast. And in symplast movement of water take place from one cell to another cell. And during its movement from one cell to another cell, there is also movement of solutions like that. And from it, when it goes both apoplast and symplast process, when it reaches the endodermis, then it follows the same symplastic way of movement. And after that, again in symplast stages, it move again cell to cell connection, and water move like this up to the xylem. From here, the xylem it move upward to the plant. For example, take it as a plant. Here it is moved upward to the plant through the xylem, to the upward movement is, and that is called as ascent of cell. So in next video I will teach you on ascent of cell. Till then, wait for it.